Good evening. My name is Julie Dunn. I'm the Operations Director at Resurrection, and it is my honor to have a chance to share a word with you tonight. So thank you for being here. It's a beautiful but very breezy evening in the backyard, but it's nice to see the sun shining again. Things are flourishing and growing. Grass is definitely getting longer again. We just mowed on, I think it was on Sunday afternoon. There's Lita, and I think we're going to have to mow again here in a couple days. So welcome. Thanks for being here. Now that spring is here, I think like most everyone else, I've been working in the backyard and been getting things kind of straightened up and cleaned up. Like I said, we mowed again on Sunday, and now it's Tuesday, and I'm pretty confident we're going to have to get back out here again by tomorrow. We have not a huge yard. It's just pretty small, but we like it. It's comfortable, and it does take work, but it's definitely an effort of love that we thoroughly enjoy. When I was growing up, my grandparents on my mom's side lived on a little farm just over into the Minnesota, on the Minnesota side. And they had a huge garden, great big strawberry patch, and a pretty good sized raspberry patch. And so when I was growing up, I would go up and stay for about a week during the summer, and it was just wonderful. I loved spending time with my grandparents. And so my grandma largely took care of the garden and did most of the strawberry stuff, except for spreading out the straw. And my grandpa did most of the tending of the raspberry patch. And even in the summertime, he would have his straw hat on, and he would wear a long sleeve flannel shirt. And as I grew, I came to understand why he had to protect himself. I would be out in the garden with Grandma and Grandpa, and Grandma would keep me by her, and she was pretty patient. I would be helping, you know, and I'm going to do air bunny quotes on that. I would sit down on top of big strawberries and that we were supposed to be picking, but she was very patient, and I would pick the peas and I would eat them out of the shells, and she'd barely have any to cook, but she loved me and it was okay. I understood as I got a little older that she kept me out of the raspberries until I was old enough to understand that they were very thorny and prickly, and I needed to be big enough to put on a flannel shirt and tend them with them. And so as I grew, I understood and saw Grandpa pruning them and tending them. He would be pruning out the old canes, and he would be trimming back the newer ones. And it just was part of what he did. And I never really thought about asking why or what the reason was that he did that. And Grandpa passed away when I was about 11 or 12. And the last 4 years he wasn't on the farm. He'd had a stroke. And so I just didn't really get to ask those questions. I was just kind of too little and not really that interested. So fast forward, when Greg and I got married and I moved in here, we planted some raspberry bushes because he grew up in Hopkins, and they grow lots and lots. There used to be huge fields of raspberries, and they still have Raspberry Festival in Hopkins, at least when they're able to. And so we both love raspberries, and so we decided to buy a few plants, and we put them in here at the end of the deck. And they, like I said, it's not a huge patch, but they have grown, and they have like the southern exposure, and they've done well. So what I have learned about raspberries is that they have pretty much a 2-year life cycle. So these are in their second year, And you can see that I have trimmed off the end, took my little pruning shear out and trimmed them back. And then down here are new ones, little green ones. And these are going to be the ones that will bear fruit next year. Well, what I also learned is that raspberries will bear a lot more fruit all the way down the cane when you trim them back. And then after they have done their bearing that second year, you have to cut the dead canes out. And I think I have gotten them all out of here already, so I don't see any more. But it's important to continue to tend them every year. So it got me thinking about Jesus when he gave us the example that he is the vine, like a grapevine, and that we are the branches as believers. And God is the gardener, and he tends them. He tends us. And so when we stray from his rules, then we have to be corrected. And it's that way with every parental relationship, and it's the most loving thing we can do. In the book of John, in chapter 15, Jesus said, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. I am the vine, and you are the branches. If you remain in me, and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire, and burned. But if you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit." So we're like these second year canes of raspberries. They have to be trimmed back in order to bear a lot of fruit. And I have learned some of my greatest lessons when I have had to be corrected and had to be trained or pruned back because of something I've said or done. A wise man said, "You're closest to the vine dresser, the gardener, when you're being pruned." And that is really true, because it's in those hardest times that I have gotten closest to Jesus. So the same is true here. Correction from God is the most loving thing that he can do as our Father. Now, if you are a parent, I think you might have had to teach your children lessons. You had to learn to say no. I have a friend who some years ago had a little boy, and he was a toddler, and she said, "Oh, I should say no to him, but he's just so cute." Well, she didn't get in the habit of saying no. And now, fast forward some years later, she is really paying the price, and I love her, and I hope that she has learned better ways to put some boundaries out for her kids, because it's the most loving thing we can do. The same is true for all of us. We're just like these raspberry canes. When we're pruned back, when we're corrected by our loving God, we bear more fruit than if we are just left unchecked. So maybe you're struggling. Maybe you're struggling with saying no. I am not great at it. I am not great at saying no. I get bowled over pretty easily, and so I really wrestle with that pretty much every day. I know I should, but I'm just not great at standing up for myself and saying no. And so that's something that is in my prayer, that I can learn to do better at that. If you're the same, join the struggle with me and pray. Pray that God will step in, hand that struggle, that weakness over, and allow him to help you, because he can and he will. It is the most loving thing. It is truly the best thing we can do. It gets easier. It will get easier, and it does get better. And seeing that cane bear a lot of fruit is a great thing because of that. So I would just invite you to pray with me and work toward saying no and allowing yourself to be pruned and realize that the greatest freedom and the greatest fruit to be to come from you in Jesus' name is by surrendering that. So please pray with me. Lord, help us to receive your correction and help us to receive your loving hand as you come close and you guide us to do what is pleasing for you. Help us to stay within your will, for you have promised that your abundance will be given when we abide within you. So Lord, we invite you into this. We ask that you would help us, and that you would help us to most of all bear fruit that would be pleasing to you, that your name may be glorified. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, I'm gonna head back in. Thank you for joining me. Our next devotion is going to be tomorrow night. We are now doing the live devotions Monday nights through Thursday nights at 6:30. And we still offer prayer in the parking lot at 5:14. We'll have drive-in worship on Sunday at 9 a.m. at the Resurrection parking lot. We have inside worship at Oak Grove, and our 9 o'clock and 10:30 worship online on Facebook, as well as YouTube, will still be available this Sunday. So join us. Until then, blessings. Thank you for being here. In Jesus' name, I thank you. Bye.